If you're here, thank you for clicking on my first video to my new channel titled
I Said What I Said.
This channel is going to be based on me telling and giving y'all tea on situations and speaking on my behalf of how I feel about it. That's why it's titled
I Said What I Said.
The old channel where I did this on ATAS Reacts was more professional. This channel is going to be more on based on me telling y'all the tea how I want to and giving my opinion how I want to.
Period.
So now that you did your part on by clicking on this video and watching it, you may also do your part and click that motherfucking subscribe button. Now head to the motherfucking intro. Let's get to this motherfucking tea. Let's go.
I said what I said.
Bitch, worth the vibe, yo. Niggas know the vibe, that's worth the five, yo. Beef, we about to resolve, yo. Pull up on the op, do we have a problem?
Hey, yo, baby, let's go.
Alright, y'all, if you follow me on Instagram at ATS Darkroom, you had the chance to vote and you guys voted to talk about this topic of Megan Thee Stallion, Party, and Tory Lanez, which just happened. So we finna hop right into this motherfucking shit. This situation is so old and ran through that I'm not gonna be telling that. Why?
Ain't nobody got time for that.
Anyways, to keep you up to date of what happened, Tory and Megan allegedly talked. Tory got caught messing with Megan's best friend. Happened to be drunk one night in the car. Megan was whooping Tory's ass. Tory shot her allegedly on an accident. Megan went live clearing it up. She ain't snitched. Then they have been going to court about the situation. Label and Tory been throwing shots at Meg. And now Meg is at her bursting point and goes off and talks that shit to both of them. But the real question is, who is telling the damn truth? That's what I want to know. I want y'all to comment down like right motherfucking now. Tell me like, whose side is y'all on? Is y'all team Tory? Is y'all team Megan? Or y'all just like, fuck both of them. Both of them lying. Both of them had shit they did. Both of them did something bad. Tell me down in the comments below. But for me, what I honestly think what happened was Tory was messing with old girl. Got caught. They were already drunk. Tory Lanez was in a car. They were arguing. Megan was whooping his 5'2 ass. Megan then gets out the car. Then Tory was angry that he got his ass whooped, pointed the gun out the window, and shot her. That's what I believe happened. And to make this clear, because she said she was pulling out lawsuits to any blog that's telling lies, this is how and what I think happened. This is not the true story. Had to make that clear, because the motherfucker can't afford to get sued.
Absolutely not. Not me. Certainly not I.
Yesterday, I ain't even gonna cap. One of the biggest motherfucking problems in motherfucking rap history. Fat ass academics had started this one. He did start this one. He was the one that had to drop some news that wasn't even true. He decided to post a tweet saying, breaking, it was revealed in court a few minutes ago that Tory Lanez DNA was not found on a weapon in the Meg Thee Stallion case. The thing was, court ain't even started yet, so I don't know where academics got this information from or where did he get it from, but Meg went off. After Meg was going off, Tory Lanez then inserted himself saying, you can't buy and tweet your way out this one, not today.
Wait a damn minute. What?
I'm like, oh, not Tory then jumped in. So after Tory then jumped in, Meg then came out with messages of Tory apologizing. Tory responded, said, the messages ain't from that night. The messages is me apologizing for messing with your best friend. And then that's when Megan continued going on Tory. Megan continued going on 8K. And then here's this part. The reporter then said there was zero mention of DNA at the Tory Lanez hearing today. The report that Tory Lanez lawyer told court DNA results were pleasing to his side is totally fabricated. Two sources telling Rolling Stone, I'm about to receive the transcript, will update. Pre-trial continued to April 5th. So therefore, Meg might not be lying, but whatever academics was talking about, some DNA and all that, he was just lying. He just wanted to be a messy power bottom like he always is. Oh, he always is in the female rapper business. Let's not forget when he was all up in Nicki Minaj's business and Nicki Minaj had to threaten his ass to sit his ass down. Then it basically went on from partisan trying to link with Tory Lanez. Tory Lanez saying there ain't no reason to link. This or that. Third, at this point, they need to go to court. It need to be on TV. And we just need to figure out the truth. I mean, what I could say is I don't think this would even be continuing if there wasn't enough proof of or anything that happened at night. Like, there has to be proof for it to be continuously going on, because if not, I believe the case would have been, like, you know, thrown away. But there got to be some evidence, so we're going to keep an eye on that. Please make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe. Share to all your friends to keep up with this new channel that we will be doing. I think the next video that y'all do want is the Nicki and Cardi one. So, yeah, hit the subscribe button. Love y'all. Peace out.
I said what I said.
Bitch worth a five, yo. Niggas know the vibe, that's worth a five, yo.